Podcast number 19, plastics. This slide shows different types of plastics, from juice in milk bottles, carrier bags, children's scoops, clothes pegs, right through to wall sockets. But do you know where plastics come from? Well, today, plastics as we know them don't exist naturally. In fact, 99% of plastic used throughout the world are manufactured from oil and natural gas. This heavy petrol undergoes treatment called steam cracking. Why is it called this? Because raising the temperature and the presence of steam breaks down the heavy molecules into lighter molecules which contain only a few atoms of carbon. These light molecules, which will be used to make the plastics, are called petrochemical bases. So let's look at a picture of the process of making plastic. Well, oil and gas is usually removed from the earth or under the sea. It's chemically refined in a refinery, produces molecules with a few carbon atoms, which then allow us to make different types of plastics. Plastics can be broken down into two groups, thermoplastic and thermosetting plastic. Thermoplastics soften on heating and harden on cooling. They can be reshaped and reformed many times, and they can be recycled. Acrylic, polythene and polyesters are all examples of thermoplastics. Thermosetting plastics are very heat resistant, but they will burn if they're heated too much. They're only formed into shape once and that's it, and they can also be recycled. Epoxy resins, Bakelite and urea formaldehyde are examples of thermosets or thermosetting plastics. Now let's look at some manufacturing processes with plastics. Injection moulding. Molten plastics injected under high pressure into a cooled split mould to produce a high precision moulding. We can use this type of manufacturing to make buckets, telephones, TV cabinets, gears and toys. Blow moulding. A hot thermoplastic tube is inflated by compressed air into a split cavity mould to produce a hollow moulding. Examples of this are bottles, drums and car petrol tanks. Extrusion. Molten thermoplastic is extruded under high pressure through a shaped die to produce a continuous precision section. Drain pipe, guttering, water pipe, window frames and insulation wire are examples of this. Compression moulding. Thermosetting plastic powder is compressed and heated in a matched die set to produce a precision moulding. Fuse boxes, lamp holders, saucepan handles and insulators are made this way. Rotational moulding. A thermoplastic powder is tumbled, heated and cooled in a split hollow mould to produce a hollow moulding of a simple shape. Litter bins, balls and traffic bollards are examples. And vacuum forming. A thermoplastic sheet is heated and forced under vacuum into contact with a cooled mould to produce a simple shape. Yogurt pots, vending cups and fridge linings are examples of vacuum forming. Why don't you ask your teacher to show you vacuum forming in the workshop?